Google Maps is much more than a navigation app. It's a global database. You can easily retrieve data from your competitors by scraping what their consumers say about them. Then you can sort your value out based on the number of stars, based on a date, or based on a specific keyword found in the review content. On today's video, we will scrape reviews from Google Maps, and we will do it for free thanks to Octoparse. The link to download it is in the description. One last thing, if you want to scrape Google Maps at scale, you can also use scrap.io. It will help you to get thousands or more leads, including emails, phone numbers, overall ratings, and number of reviews. The first 100 leads are free. The link is also in the description. As an example, I'm going to scrape a historic monument. First thing you have to do is to click on reviews. I copy my URL and I paste it on Octoparse. I click on start. You will end up with a pop-up. I invite you to remove it. I turn on the browse mode. I click on reject all and I've got my reviews. In order to make sure that the pop-up won't appear anymore, we also have to save the cookies. Therefore, I go to the options, I click on use cookie from the current page, and I click on apply. The most important step is to create a scroll page element. We'll scroll down to the bottom of the page, just here, in order to load as many reviews as we can. It's very unlikely we will get all 5,000 reviews, but we can scrape around, let's say, 1,000 of reviews per location. I add a step and I'm going to create a new loop. But as we have said, this loop will be a scroll page element. I'm going to name it scroll, and I change the scroll area from default to partial. Indeed, this is a partial scroll area since the scroll bar is located within a part of my web page. I have to insert an XPath in order to precisely localize where my scroll area is. And as I've repeated several times on this channel, it's always better to learn how to write your own XPath. So let's write the first one together. I come back to my browser, and I'm going to analyze to take a look at the HTML code of my web page. I click and select an element in the page to inspect it, and I want to include my scroll bar. In order to write and to verify my XPath, I usually use the XPath helper, which is a Chrome extension. I'm going to start with this element, and I will select the attribute role and the value main. So my XPath will look something like this. Then I'm going to select my second child, div, and I want to select the second one. I copy it, I paste it, and I click on apply. Then you have a couple of options to choose. I invite you to scroll to the bottom of the page. Even though you can also scroll one screen at a time. Let's say we will repeat the scrolling process 1,000 times. You can say 10,000 times if you want to, because it won't matter as long as you keep this box checked. As a waiting time, I invite you to set up a higher timeout. Something like 5 or 10 seconds should be enough. I click on apply. We will select our reviews. That will be our second step. All the XPaths I'm gonna use will be written in the description, but please note that they might change over time. I'm going to add another loop, but this time the purpose of this loop will be to select our reviews. As a loop mode, I select variable list and I insert my second XPath. I click on apply. Let's check it out. And I've got 8 items. All of the items are unlighted in green for the first one, and the remaining ones are in red. Our third step is to extract our data. Let's just add a timeout, something like 1 second. And let's move on. I add a step and I extract data. Let's begin with the reviewer name. I copy my XPath. And here is a process you have to follow to extract your data. I click on Add Custom Field, Capture Data on the page. I always select Relative XPath to the loop item. I input my XPath and I give it a name. And I click on Apply and Confirm. And I don't directly get the reviewer name. Actually, I get all the content of my reviews. So let's clean our data a little bit, shall we? I click on More, Clean Data. Add step, match with regular expression, try the RegEx tool, and we are going to write a RegEx that will allow us to select this part of our text. Actually, it's not accurate enough, so before that, I'm going to change my cells from a text format to a HTML format. I click on More, Customize Field, and select Author HTML. Now I click on More, Clean Data. Let's write our XPath. I click on Start With, End With. As you can notice, what precedes our text is IR label equal and the quotation mark. And it ends with another quotation mark. I click on Generate, Match, and I've got my name. I click on Apply, Confirm, and Apply, and I've got all my names. Let's move on with the review date. The review date is a bit tricky as well because you have to insert two XPaths for the same column. I add a custom fill, capture date on the page. I insert the first one here and the second one here. I select relative XPath to the loop item and let's take that one. I'm going to scrape the review count as well. It helps you to scrape an element with a span tag and with a text that contains the word review and not reviews because you can write one review. The process remains the same. There is something you can do, however, because you've got a dot and I wish to remove it. I'm going to clean my data one more time. This time I will replace an element by another one. I'm going to replace this part of my text by nothing. In other words, it will simply remove it. The rating is similar to the review count, but this time we're going to select an element with a value that contains the word star. A problem occurs because we don't get the rating. To solve this problem, we have to click on More, Customize Field, select Author HTML, like we have done previously, and we're going to clean our data by writing a regex. So starts with end with contain one. It starts with this. It ends with that character. And it contains the word star. I generate, I match, I apply, I confirm, and I apply. And I've got my rating, the number of like. We select an element that contains the text like, and we select the following sibling, which means the element below. Finally, our content. There is something more we can do. We can click on More in order to make sure we will get the entire content and not just a part of it. But the More button is not always displayed for every reviews. This is why we have to create a condition. The condition number one will be if there is more, we click on it and we extract the entire content. Option two, if there is no word more, we scrape the data as usual. I add a step and I'm going to create a branch conditions. This might sound difficult, but actually it's not that much. The first condition will be if long reviews, and option B, if short reviews. I drag my loop item within the if short reviews condition. For this condition, I keep always execute the branch checked. But for that one, I click on execute if the current loop contains specific text. What kind of text are we looking for? We are looking for the text more. We will click on an element. I click on my click item. I go to the options. I will wait, let's say, 1 second before clicking on my element. I click to unload with Ajax with a timeout of 10 seconds. And I'm going to write an XPath. Let's write that one. I've got my more element. So it will be something like /bottom contains text equal, no, comma, more. Here it is. I copy it and I insert it here. I click on apply. Let's check it out. We've got our entire content. I click on my loop item. I copy it, I paste it, and I drag my very same loop item on extract data step within my A condition. I click on save, I click on run, and I click on standard mode. I see you back for the results. Our task is completed. Let's take a look. I click on show browser. I just want to know why it stops. And it seems we didn't succeed in reaching the bottom of the page, but we've got more than 1,000 lines, so I'm pretty happy with that. I click on export, I click on OK, and here is what it should look like. This is the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If it's the case, feel free to give a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. If you had any problem regarding this tutorial, you can also ask for help in the comments. And if you wish you could scrape Google Maps at a bigger scale, there is still scrap.io. The link is in the description. See you next time.